السلام علیکم.
وعلیکم السلام ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ.
Is suicide under any circumstances justified in Islam?
But that's the question, that is suicide under any circumstances justified in Islam? My counter question, what do you mean by suicide? Suicide means a person wants to end his life. And most of the cases, suicide per se, is a person who's fed up of life. He has got so many problems, you know, he doesn't have money or he's got a loss of business, whatever, and then he ends his life. This is haram in Islam. Ending your life purposely because of troubles in this world is haram. But on the other hand, you say that I want to fight for the haq. Time Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the enemies who fought against the Prophet, and you say, I'm going. We know that we are a small number. We are 300, they are 1,000, three times more. The chance of us surviving is little. In normal terminology, it will cause suicide. So that time, fine, I want to fight for the haq. And while doing that, I'm ready to die. That's a different question. So you'll become a martyr. The question of suicide per se, you should define what does it mean. And I know that your reference may be in context to suicide bombing. Correct? Suicide bombing or, you know, going for a particular thing. You know, the question didn't say that, but I'm in the field. You know, so more of suicide bombing. Is the difference between suicide bombing and committing suicide. Suicide per se is haram. But if you ask me, suicide bombing, as I said, individual case you have to analyze what the individual case say. If it's one individual who takes a decision and does it, it's totally haram in Islam. And under normal circumstances, Allah says in the Quran, Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 32, that if you kill any human being, unless it be for murder or for creating mischief in the land, it is as though you have killed the whole of humanity. And if you save any one human being, it is as though you have saved the whole of nation. So killing any human being, unless it be for murder or for creating mischief, it is haram. But now under circumstances, if you analyze, at the name of the Sahaba, what they did, if you call it modern terminology, it is called as suicide. So what we have to realize, that individual person taking a decision is totally haram. The scholars are divided. Some group of scholars say that under any circumstances, suicide bombing is haram. Lashid Nasruddin Albani, Sheikh Utaimi, Sheikh bin Baz, all these three great stalwarts who expired recently, all of them say that suicide bombing, suicide killing under any circumstances is haram. But there are other scholars, like Sheikh Salman Auda, he is, mashallah, one of the great scholars of this time. He says that if under normal circumstances, it's haram. But if the situation demands, like in Palestine, every day they are being killed and thousands are being killed throughout the year. So it is rather that they have to fight in self-defense. And if they know that they use an attack in which the chances of dying are there, and if they really cause a damage to the opponent, as a last resort, with guidance from a scholar who has not, that one individual person gets up in the night and says, okay, fine, I'll go out. So with guidance of the Quran and Sunnah, as a last resort, it can be used. And they give examples. They give examples from Hadith, giving their own logical argument. You analyze that there was once when the fort was being taken up by the enemies, and the Sahaba, they said, you throw me over, and then I will go on to the spear. So chance of dying was there. Yet they went, he didn't die, and he opened the door. So there are exceptions to the rule, so scholars differ. One group of scholars say it's totally haram under any circumstances. Some scholars say, as a last resort, if it's done with guidance, there's no other alternative. Because the person doesn't want to end his life. He wants to fight for the cause of haq, for truth. And while doing that, the chances of his dying is very high. And I know that one person was arguing with me a lot. One of the person, Mandai, he told me, under any circumstances it's haram. So I asked him a question. Now suppose there is someone who comes to attack the Prophet. Hypothetical. And if you are present in between, and you come in between the crossfire, he's firing. You know that if you jump in between, you're going to die. But while dying, you save the Prophet. Will you jump? Of course I'll jump. But that's suicide. But it's haram. For the Prophet, I'll do it. But now you're saying suicide is haram. Then how come you come in between? And there are various other options. No, but then he changed. He said, no. You know, the people who are good in arguing, they change. No, but there, the trigger wasn't pulled by him. Trigger was pulled by somebody else. What I'm telling, if the trigger is pulled by the person himself, then it is haram. Yeah, the trigger is pulled by the enemy. Suppose there's a person who's very good, hefty, etc. He's there. He wants to kill the Prophet. And you come in between. And you catch his hand. And now what happens? That the gun is turned. And to kill him, you have to kill yourself also. And if you pull the trigger, you will die and the person will die and the Prophet will be saved. Then what will you do? Will you pull the trigger or not? Hadith says a person who doesn't love Allah and the Prophet more than himself, his wife and his family. He's not a mu'min. Will you pull the trigger? He said yes. But that's suicide. Imagine, and it's a situation which happens. It can happen, not that it is vague. You are there, and if you pull the trigger, you will die, and then, and you are pulling the trigger. You are killing yourself and killing him. and a prophet will be saved. So I do agree with Sheikh Salman Oda. As a last resort, if under certain circumstances you know that the loss that is there is less and the gain is more, following all the rules of the Sharia, following the Quran, Sahih Hadith, as a last resort, under guidance, not that you get up in the morning and take a decision on your own, it's totally haram, killing any human being is haram. In that context, as a last resort, it can be used, and I do agree with Sheikh Salman Oda. Hope that answers the question.